3, 2, 1. Welcome back to 10 Minute Talks with D-Ray, the talk show tailored towards those of us with a short attention span. Here with my man, Derek Wesley, and we're just going to jump right into it. We got a lot to talk about. Like I said, we got 10 minutes. So please tell us what IMR Learning Solutions is.
All right, D-Ray, thank you for having me, man. I appreciate it. IMR Learning Solutions. So our main focus is to help our users improve their critical thinking skills and also their financial literacy education, because I'm a teacher. I've been teaching for about 9 years now. Mm-hmm. And back in February 2019, I actually entered into TD Ameritrade's innovation contest. And I was actually, out of 135 applicants, I realized that this is something that's powerful and important to people, that they need to learn how to improve their financial knowledge. Mm-hmm. And I was actually one of the top three contestants. And they didn't tell me that Robert Hirschberg from Shark Tank, he was going to be one of the guest judges. And so here I am. I get to present to over 2,000 financial advisors to talk to them about why I think financial literacy should be taught in schools. Yeah. And out of the three competitors, I actually won the grand prize, because the financial advisors that I met there, I was surprised. They actually felt the exact same way. And they told me, they said, it doesn't matter if you come from a low-income neighborhood. It doesn't matter if you're a millionaire, you still need to know how to manage your finances, because some of them, they said they had clients. One lady said, yeah, my client, she had $5 million in the bank 1 year. A year later, she had $2 million. Then the next year, $1 million. We're on the phone crying with each other because she's mad at me, because she said, why didn't you tell me I was wasting my money? She said, I tried to tell you. You didn't want to listen. You didn't want to stop spending. And so that was an eye-opener for me, that let me see that it doesn't matter where you come from, you need to know how to manage your finances. And my heart and my soul goes out to my low-income students that don't learn these lessons. They don't have parents at home teaching them these things. And maybe it's because the parent might be in jail. Maybe it's because a lot of my students, some of them are homeless. They have a lot of different situations that they're dealing with. And I created a solution that, if the parent isn't there, then they can my students can download my app that we created, so that they can start to get some of these lessons, and they can learn from financial advisors, from athletes that are now entrepreneurs, and different people that are worried and concerned about them, making sure that they have the tools that they need to be successful in life when it comes to their finances.
Yeah. So how did you take that lesson? I don't ever want to say dumb it down, but how did you make that lesson something, I guess I'll say, fundamental enough for younger children to understand?
So that was one of the most important things, like you said, not say dumb it down. Mm-hmm. I look at it like this. It's gonna sound weird at first, but I like to see my students struggle a little. Mm-hmm. I like to get them right to that level where, okay, they're like, okay, this is a little bit too much. Mm-hmm. Then that's when I can step in and then kind of coach them along the way. And so inside of the app, one of the things that we have is, when you first download the Seedling Planet app, you take a chart assessment, okay, in the areas of financial psychology, entrepreneurship, and also budgeting. And then the app builds out a personalized curriculum for each user, because guess what? When it comes to financial education, everyone's on a different level. Everybody's learned something different, just like my reading students, just like math students. And in the school system, we focus on that and make sure that, you know, we level that off for the students when it comes to that. But what about financial education? No, everyone's learned something different. So you need content that's on your level. Mm-hmm. And so then from there, so after you complete your assessment, mm-hmm. then if you are, let's say, a lower level student, you don't have a whole lot of financial knowledge, then I'm going to feed you content based on that. But let's say if you're a 22-year-old student and you have a high level of financial knowledge because you learned a lot along the way, then I don't need to give you the lower level stuff. You need higher level stuff so that you can grow from where you're at. And so that's something that's very important inside of the app that no one else is doing. Because like I said, being in the school system, we do things like that for reading, math, and science. But then when it comes to financial education, we don't do that.
Yeah. So it's so many things that, like, I understand that these kids, and it's funny, it's just, we were talking about it before we started. I was like, these kids, with their ability to use this technology, I remember Steve Jobs was talking about he wanted the personal computer to be like a bicycle for the brain. And if this is a race, they're about to blow all of us away. Like how smart they're going to be. And this is going to add on to it. The financial part is going to add on to it. What's the most common, I guess, gap in knowledge have you seen when it comes to older people? Like not necessarily, I guess, you know, between in our age bracket, you know, late 20s, pretty much up until like 50. What is like the general, you know, gap in the knowledge you see?
I think the most important gap in the knowledge is that in our Black community, for example, we don't invest. And I know growing up that was something, nope, you don't invest your money, you're gonna lose it in the stock market, this is gonna happen, that all these bad things are gonna happen. But then when I see on the news nowadays, everybody's having so much success doing these different things. Why? Because they invested years ago. A buddy of mine, he said, yeah, my grandfather, he bought me stock in Disney when I was like 2, and I haven't done anything with it. I just get checks from that now. I'm like, wow, why don't we have things like that in our community? And so that's something that's very important to me. And I think more of our Black and brown folks need to be investing and watching their money grow and learn how their money can work for them instead of living, constantly living check to check, and learn to pay yourself first and then put that money away and save it and invest it so that it can continue to grow. And that's something that's really, really missing in the communities that I work with and where I'm from.
Yeah, I feel you. I feel you. So what do you think it looks like when everybody has this knowledge? Like in 20 years, when these fundamental lessons in finance, from investing to saving your money to, you know, understanding how to just, I'm not going to say work the bank system, but how to work with the bank system, understanding credit, like what do you think that world looks like?
I think that world is going to look like everyone less stress, because I know my mom and dad growing up, they stressed over finances. And so it limited the things that we could do as far as vacations, exploring the world and doing different things and being able to look at the world in a different through different lenses. And so I think once everyone is able to take that stress away of when it comes to stressing over finances, then you can actually find the job that you really want and care about, not something that you just have to do so you can make money to pay the bills. You can find what you're passionate about, and then you're happy, you know, because that's something that's missing, because everyone, you usually just have to find a job, pay the bills. You're not ever actually able to chase that dream. Yeah. Because you have to pay the bills. But when you're able to find that thing that you love, then if money's not the issue, then you can focus on that thing that you're passionate about. Even with our company, Seedling Financial Literacy, helping people with their money and learning how to use their money is something that I'm passionate about. And so when I wake up in the morning, I'm happy to be able to do that. And we're still, you know, early stage startup, but I can see the light at the end of the tunnel, you know, that wow, this is something that's important to me, helping other people. That's why I went into teaching. It doesn't pay a lot of money, as everyone knows, but other jobs that I had in the past, I wasn't helping anyone. And I would come home from work and I'm like, this isn't for me. I don't like this. And then I realized I like helping people. And if I'm doing that, then I'm happy. And then I found a way to build a company where I'm helping people and getting these wonderful stories that I get from my students when I'm working with them about, wow, I didn't know anything about this, Mr. Wesley, about budgeting. I'm going home and talking to my parents about this. I want to start investing, Mr. Wesley. How can I start doing that? And just seeing that, it just really makes my day.
That's amazing, man. That's amazing. I love to hear your passion for this, like in your voice. Like you said, you had other jobs that like, all right, yeah, it pays the bills, but it's not. Yeah. It's not completely fulfilling you.
Yeah. So, and I think that's what's missing for a lot of people, that fulfillment. And once you find that thing and you're able to take that stress or that money, you know, not bills and not being able to pay them, take that away, then life gets a lot better.
Absolutely, man. Where people find it? I know you said it's an app, Seedling app.
Yeah, go to seedling.com, SEEDLYNG.com, and then you'll be able to see some of the amazing things we're doing with our students and their parents, and you can actually download the app. The app is called Planet, PLAN-IT, Finance. It's available for Android, it's available for Apple, and yeah, check it out, take a spin. It's free to download it. You get your first set of lessons free. You can create a budget inside the app for free. And even if you don't know how to create a budget, put in how much you make per year, and then our technology is going to tell you what you should put aside for your budget for each category. And once you're about 85% through your budget, we'll actually start sending you notifications also. Saying, hey, D-Ray, you're about 85% through. Let's look back at some of these previous lessons. And the reason why I did that is because, like with my students, if they're not getting something, then we got to go back and look at some of the lessons that I taught them to help them get back on track.
It's amazing, man. Thank you, man. Thank you so much. I said, we. I'm thinking that's just about 10 minutes, but thank you so much.
And we can talk about this all day.
I was about to say, not only for joining me on this, but like just creating something like this. You know what I mean? I could imagine the contest like that. There's a million different ideas that could do X, Y, and Z and satisfy you and help you. And it's like the fact that you used it to help so many people. I appreciate that, man.
Love it. Love it. Thank you, man. And hey, the story's just starting. Exactly. Got a long way to go. A lot more people to help.
Exactly, man. Exactly. Thank y'all for tuning in. This has been 10 Minute Talks with D-Ray, the talk show tailored towards those of us with a short attention span. I gotta keep saying that again.
Love it.
Like I said, he's Derek Wesley, man. Definitely make sure y'all download that app and just teach yourselves, man. Educate yourselves on what y'all can and what y'all can't. They're there to help y'all with, man. Thank you.
Love it. Thank you.
Amen.